ओके गाइस, नमस्ते एवरीवन, कैन यू हियर मी?
नमस्ते
नमस्ते
नमस्ते,
हाउ आर यू गाइस?
आई एम डूइंग फाइन सर.
आई एम वेल, थैंक यू. आई एम
माइसेल्फ सूरज एंड आई एम फ्रॉम ऋषिकेश. आई टीच traditional hatha yoga and ashtanga vinyasa and adjustment alignment, and I have been teaching past 5 years in Rishikesh. And in this course, in this class, I will teach you the adjustment alignment of the postures. Okay, so I'm excited to share my knowledge with you through this class and to push you and to guide you through your yogic journey. So are you excited?
Yes, thank you
so much.
Okay, so one by one, everybody introduce yourself. Yes.
You call out the name and then we'll meet.
Yes. Okay, already. Okay. Okay. Door baitho, just a minute. Okay. Mariam, Asmina, and Radhika. Okay, guys. Anadia. Who is Anadia? Okay. Okay, guys. So today, we will be talk about the adjustment alignment of the postures. Today topic is open pelvic postures. Okay. Today, we will talk about how to do the open pelvic postures. Okay, in a standing postures, we have a three parts. One is open pelvic postures, so your pelvic is open. The second, your pelvic is closed, so closer pelvic posture. And third one is balancing posture. I think one more person are adding. Just a minute, guys. Okay, guys. So today we will talk about open pelvic postures. Okay. So anybody know it? Any open pelvic posture name?
Open pelvic Konasana.
Konasana. Very good. Very good. Baddha Konasana is one of the open pelvic postures. Okay. And in a standing, Baddha Konasana is the sitting open pelvic postures. And in a standing posture,
Trikonasana.
Very good. Radhika. The Trikonasana, yes, very good, nice. Okay, so today we will talk about how to do the open pelvic posture in standing. Okay, yes, so let's start the session. Sit in simple cross leg, palms onto the knees, spine should be straight, your eyes should be closed. Relax your mind, relax your face muscles, relax your shoulder, observe your breath, deep inhalation, deep exhalation, just feel your breath. Feel your belly in and out, out to in. Gently join the palm in front of the chest, Anahata Chakra. We are going to chant 3 times Oms together, then Santi. Take a deep breath in. Oh. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Move your head down. For your God, for your Guru, for your parents to give a life, give a knowledge. Move your head up. Take a deep breath in. Open your eyes with the exhalation. Just feel the light on your eyes. Namaste. Okay, guys. So first, the one question for you. Okay, guys. So what is the reason we are using the alignment in the class? Always, every teacher using this word, correct your alignment. So what is the benefits of the correct alignment? Because this is the alignment session, so we know about it, why we are doing correct alignment.
So that we can breathe properly.
Very nice. Very good. Nice.
So you get the benefit of the pose if you do it the pose correctly, the asana.
Yes. Okay, so what is the asana? The most important question, because today we are talking about asana. So what is the meaning of asana?
Posture, asana. Pose.
Yes. But when we call this is the posture?
When we are comfortable in it.
Very nice. So one sutra is sthiram sukham asanam. So in this posture, if you are comfortable, stable and concentrate, this is called posture. Okay. Just right now, I just take an example. We are sitting simple cross leg. Spine should be straight. This is the posture. Everybody are comfortable in this posture. Sitting simple cross leg, spine should be straight. This is the posture. Spine should be straight. So this is posture, guys. Can you hear me?
Yes. Louder. Can you just go a little louder, sir?
Okay. Just a minute. इसकी वॉइस बढ़ेगी इतनी होगी इतनी होगी ओके गाइस तो कैन यू हेयर मी
यस सर यस
ओके सो माय क्वेश्चन इज व्हेन वी कॉल दिस इज द पोस्चर जस्ट वी टेक अ सिटिंग सिंपल क्रॉस लेग एंड इफ यू हैव अ हंच ऑन अ बैक सो दिस इज पोस्चर बट राइट नाउ आई एम कंफर्टेबल सो दिस इज कॉल्ड पोस्चर और नॉट This is posture. If my spine is not straight, this is called posture?
No.
I'm feeling comfortable. If my spine is not straight, I'm feeling comfortable. Okay, I'll give you one example. If so what is the benefit of the straight spine? I'll ask you a question for a What is the benefit of the straight spine?
It is not overstretching or understretching anything. Like not overstretching any muscle.
Okay.
If the spine is straight, sir, if the spine is straight, we will be able to breathe in properly.
Very nice. So that's the reason we are feeling comfortable, because if we are breathing properly, energy level, we have a energy to this energy reaching into the mind and body, then we are easily comfortable and we can concentrate into the posture. Then we are comfortable. That's why our spine should be straight. Or always every teacher using this word, your spine should be straight. That's why we need a correct alignment to our energy level, our balance into the body. That's why we are using the alignment. Okay, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the first posture today we will be discuss the Trikon Asana, Uthita Trikon Asana. The meaning of this posture is extended three-angle posture. Okay, have you done before this posture?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so show me how to do this posture. Then I'll first show me how to do the Trikonasana. Try, guys. Don't worry. Frankly and fearlessly, you can show how to do the Trikonasana. मुझे दिख नहीं रहे बंदे ओके गाइस यस यू कैन डू फर्स्ट लिटिल बिट मूवमेंट जॉइंट मूवमेंट देन यू कैन शो मी यस वेरी नाइस अस्मिना Show me.
I'm not sure, but I'll try.
Okay, don't wait. Yes.
I have Good. A problem with my shoulder.
Okay. So don't force. Yes. Very nice. Good. Nice. Good, Radhika. Okay, Marine. Okay, guys. Okay, so one time I'll show you how to do the Trikonasana. Okay, today we will discuss the Trikonasana posture. Okay, so he's Ravi Kant. Okay, he demonstrate you how to do the Trikonasana posture. Okay, guys. Okay. So first, come in front edge of the mat. Your toes together, heels together. Okay, guys. So you have a two variations to do the Trikonasana. The two way how to do the Trikonasana. The first way is directly jump and do this posture. And the one is Hatha Yoga. And the another one is how to do the posture in a Ashtanga. So first I show you how to do the Hatha Yoga, how to do the this posture with the Hatha Yoga, okay? So, bend the elbow. Bend your both knees. If you have a knee pain, so do not bend the knee. Just open your legs, okay? Just if you have a knee pain, so extend the knee straight. And just open your legs very gently. Open the legs 3 and 3.5 feet apart. If you are flexible, you can open your leg 4 feet apart. Okay, guys? If you are flexible, so what you will be doing, you can open your legs 4 feet apart. Okay? Inhale, arm by the side, parallel to the floor. Spread the finger. Spread your finger. Engage the arm muscles. Okay? Your arms are aligned with the shoulders. And your trunk above the pelvic. It means do not tilt your trunk like that. Clear?
Yeah.
Good. First, maintain here 20 seconds, 30 seconds in this posture. Because if you are directly going to jump into the posture, sometimes you feel the injuries. Sometimes you feel the overstretch. Take a couple of breaths. Spread the finger, arm muscles engage. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Okay, guys, relax first. You just see, then you can apply. Okay, relax. Okay, guys. First, so your right leg going to the 90 degree. So turn your right leg 90 degree towards the right side. Okay, and left leg 45 to 60 degree in. Clear? And your right heel and left middle arch. Okay, right heel. And left middle arch should be in one line. And heel to heel is also right. Your right heel and left heel in one line. This is also right. Because some teachers say right heel and left heel in one line. This is also right. But starting time, it's good to your right heel and left middle arch should be in one line. to a balance the posture. Then day by day, if you are get flexible, you have a range of motion good, you can go more deeper. Then you are heel to heel. But studying time, it's good. So your right heel and left middle arch should be in one line. Clear, guys? So the most important thing in a posture, your foundation should be strong. So right now, we work onto the foundation. Clear?
Yeah.
Good. So spread the finger, engage the arm muscles, your arms aligned with the shoulder and lifting the trunk. Don't do this, relax. Okay, so stretch, lift the outside of the trunk. Do not elevate your shoulders. Spread the finger. Clear? And the most important thing in this posture, how to go towards the right side. Most of the persons are going like that. Inhale and exhale, bend from here and place the palm. So what happened? It's hunch is coming to the left side of the trunk. So how to bend? The most important thing. Here is a ball and socket joint. This is the joint. So our goal to bend from this point. Okay. You can touch, you feel. Here is a joint to, it's called a ball and socket joint. Okay. This is the femur bone and here is a socket. So ball and socket joint is here. So your goal is to trying to bending from this point. Okay, guys. So how? Inhale, raise your right arm up, stretch your left, right side of the trunk first. Stretch, and slightly tilt from the left side. So you are feeling the stretch onto the right side of the trunk. Take a couple of breath, feel the stretch, and how to bend. Bend from this point. So press this part into the body. See, you can see this part going into the body and stretch. Go as far as possible towards the right. Stretch, and place the palm onto the ankle. Open the chest, place the left palm, left side of the waist. Good. Okay. Open the chest, look front. Good. First, open the chest. Do not drop your chest. Open the chest. Okay. And raise your left arm up, spread the finger, okay? And if you have any neck pain, so don't look up, just look front. Okay, guys? And if it's possible, so your chin back, no. First chin back. And then turn your neck towards the right side. Engage your thumb. You can see, is the difference between what we did before and right now? Okay. Clear? Inhale. How to come up? Bend the knee. Engage the core. Then inhale all the way come up. Why we are bending the knee, guys? What happened? Most of the person have a lower back pain and knee pain. So don't go fastly and don't come into the posture. If you are here, so don't just do this. So what happened? Pressure going to the lower back. And definitely this posture are not beneficial for you. This posture give you a pain. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Just a minute. I'll give, just Ravikant is flexible. Then this posture is possible for him. But the question is come if the person are not flexible, then what we will be do? Because these person are flexible, who can easily do this posture? But if person are not flexible, then what we will be do? Okay? So we will discuss if it's not possible, if you are not flexible, then what we will be do? Okay? So we are using the block. Okay? Arm by the side, alignment is same. Okay? Starting time, if it's not possible, so inhale and exhale. But just try to tilt this part. Tilt this part and depend upon your comfort. If you are possibility to place the palm onto the shin bone or your ankle, and if it's possible to use the block. Open the chest, it's not necessary ki you can go completely down. It is not necessary. The goal is your spine are extended. Because the posture name is Uthita. The Sanskrit name of this posture is Uthita Trikon Asana. So Uthita means extended. Trikon means three. A kon means angle. So Uthita Trikon, extended three angle posture. So in this posture, your spine should be extended. And day by day, this muscle will be flexible. Then you can easily reach to the toe. Okay, so first hold here, don't worry. Day by day, you can automatically go down because these muscles will allow you to go down. Right now, these muscles are not flexible, these leg muscles are not flexible, so you cannot go down. These muscles are pulling you back. That's why you have a hunch coming in this side. Okay, guys, so our goal is not to relax. Our goal is not to go completely down. Our goal is to be a, try to be align the body and this. This is fine. Don't worry. My spine is straight. This is a Trikon Asana for me. But if I have a possibility, so I can go down and place the palm onto the ankle. But I have a possibility to grab the big toe. I have a possibility. If you have a possibility to go down, place the palm onto the floor, this is also possible. But because my muscles are flexible, my muscles give me allow to go down. So I can easily go down. Clear?
Yeah.
So first, observe your body and think how to go down. If my possibility to place the palm onto the shin bone, so you can place the palm onto your shin bone. This is the shin bone. But don't place the palm onto your knee. Because if you are doing a yoga asana practice, do not push your joints. So if I'm press my joint, so it's hurting my knee. So place the palm onto the shin bone, ankle, or toe. Not possible. You can use the block. Block also have a three levels. So observe. This is the first level. If you are using this, this is the first level. The second level is this and third level is this. Okay. So you have three levels. So observe your body. Which one level is good for you? Okay, guys. Clear? So the most important thing, your foundation. Okay, so first work on to your foundation. If your foundation is good, definitely your posture will be correct. Clear? Try one time. Show me how to do the Trikon Asana. Clear? Any questions?
Yes, I want to show me the steps from. Okay, can you show me?
Okay, so first come in front, edge of the mat. I'll show you, I'll command you, then you can follow the command. Okay? So, I'll command, come in front edge of the mat, everybody. Stand up, come in front edge of the mat. Good. And little bit adjust your camera to I see you, your complete posture. Then if something is wrong, then I'll tell you that your posture is not correct. Good. Okay. So Ravikant, demonstrate you. So you follow the Ravikant step. Okay. So first, if you have a knee pain, so don't jump. Okay. So basic, just open the leg. Don't jump. Okay, guys, don't jump starting time. Okay. So bend the elbow, join the fingertips in front of the chest. Good. Okay, and open your legs 3 and 3.5 or 4 feet apart according to your comfort. 3.5 is good. Open. Good. Good. Okay. Turn your right leg towards the right side, 90 degree, and your heel and toe in one line. Turn your right leg towards the right side. Very good. Asmina, very nice. And check your right heel and left middle arch in one line or not. And left heel, left toe, 45 degree in. Yes. And arm by the side, parallel to the floor. Thoda sa aur kholo le. Open. Yes. Trunk above the pelvic, lift the chest up, deep inhale, arm by the side. Spread the finger. Very good. Asmina, you can open your legs more. Trunk above the pelvic. Good. Okay. And raise your right arm up over the head. Yes. Stretch. Yes. Your left arm. Align with your shoulder. And then inhale and the ball and socket joint going into the body and go as far as possible towards the right. Reach towards the right side. Good. Reach, stretch. Good. And place the palm onto your shin bone. Do not try to go down completely. Very good. Place the palm onto the ankle. Open the chest first. Look front first. Do not look up. Very good. And raise your left arm up. And if it's possible, any neck pain, so do not look up. And then raise your thumb. Very good. Take a couple of breaths. Deep. Any knee pain, you can micro bend the knee. 2. Good. Stretch your arm. 3. 4. And 5. Inhale or bend the knee. Engage the core. Inhale all the way, come up. Exhale. Change the side. Turn your right foot 45 degree in. Left foot. Yes. Very nice. Your left foot 90 degree. Arm by the side. Then you can see how Ravi Khan doing. Inhale, stretch your left arm up. Very good. Very good. See, he make a 90 degree, then stretch to your left side of the trunk. And then go towards the left side. Go as far as possible towards the left. Good. Place the palm, open the chest. Very good. And gaze your thumb. Very good. Good. Spread the finger and do not hang your neck. Your neck will be stable. Otherwise, you have a neck pain. Yes. Anadi. Yes. Ma'am.
I'm trying, sir.
Okay, try. Then inhale, all bend the knee, engage the core, all the way come up. Come in front, edge of the mat. Relax. Okay, guys. Fine. Any questions?
Sir, is this okay?
Yes, but you have, yes, sir, place the palm onto your shin bone. Anadi, ma'am, place the palm on. Yes. Very nice. Then open the chest and raise your arm. Raise your left arm. Very good. Are you feel the stability into the posture? Try to go more down.
Try to.
Yes, slowly more down. Very good. Open the chest and hold there. Open your leg more. Very good. Straight your knee. Right. And raise your arm. Your shoulder are not aligned. Your left arm are not aligned. Try to raise more. Yes. See? You feel that you are comfortable and body are stable. Leg muscles engage. Press the foot onto the mat strongly. Bend the knee, inhale, all the way come up.
One question.
Yes.
When you're using the block, must the block, yes. You hold the block inside your foot or outside?
Okay. It's depend upon your comfort. If you are comfortable here, it's comfortable. It's depend upon your comfort. Both side are good, but inside is more good. According to me, inside is good because you are placing the palm this side. But
okay.
When you are doing a correct Trikonasana, exact into the posture, so it is here.
Okay.
So it's a lever. Here, then one day onto the floor, and then one day here.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, guys. So you have a step. So that's why the it's a sthiram sukham asanam. So first, stable into one posture. Then day by day, you can get flexible. You can easily do the posture. Okay, clear? Are you feel the difference between what you did first and right now?
So one question.
Yes.
What did you say about the chin? That you put the chin down. You said something like that.
Yes.
That you put the chin down
it's
and then down.
Very important. Very nice. Good. Yes. What happened? It's a little bit very deeper into the posture. Go. So, its buttocks are aligned with the crown of the head. Right now, his head going moving this. So that's why I said chin back. So your crown of the back of the crown of the head are aligned with the buttocks line. And then otherwise his chin is this and then you turn. So definitely you have a cervical pain. So what we will do, chin back means chin not, it means not chin back. It means alignment, the back of crown of the head with the spine. Otherwise his neck going like that.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. I'll show you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
It means his neck is this. And then if you turn, so definitely you feel a pain. So I said first align your chin means your chin back. So it means your back of the, your cervical bone are aligned with your thoracic region. Otherwise this. And then you turn, so pain coming. That's why I said chin back. So your cervical are aligned with the thoracic region. So are you understand the anatomical terms?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes, it's good. If it's not, if you're not understand, you can tell me, then I'll explain you normally. Because the adjustment alignment class, some anatomical terms are coming, so it's a little bit typical to understand the posture. Okay. Clear, guys?
When you begin and turn the right foot, the opposite arm is up. Yes, the left arm is up.
Yes.
Right foot, yes. And left arm up. The opposite.
Yes. So right arm up. Yes, opposite. So this and my chin.
When
I'm
you,
here.
You begin.
Arm by the side. So right arm up.
Right foot, right arm up.
Yes. Then exhalation time go down. Then your left arm going higher.
Yes, okay.
Clear?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, any question, guys?
Do we always start from the right side only? Can't we start from the left side?
It's, you can start also right. Yeah, most of the time you are start with the right side.
Okay, sir.
Yes. You can start with the left side also, it's not wrong, but according to me, what happened, some reasons is, we have a right side of the right, two side of the nostrils, right side nostril, left side nostril, right side indicating to the sun energy, solar energy, and left side indicating the moon energy. Our life start with the sun. So right side is always, we are start with the right side. It's my reason. I don't know another teacher what he say, but it's my reason. That's why I said right side.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, but it's logical reason.
Yeah, logical. Yes, yes. It makes sense.
Because our life starts with if raising the sun, then your journey is a start. So that's why always with the right side. And when you will be do in future Ashtanga practice, so also with the right side. In Ashtanga practice, we did the Ashtanga. I'll show you how to do the Ashtanga, how to do the triangle posture in Ashtanga, okay? Okay. One time I'll show you just, okay? Don't do this. Ashtanga is a little bit intense. I'll just show you how to do the in Ashtanga, how to do the triangle posture. Palms onto the waist. Bend the knee. Inhale, jump towards the right side. Turn your right foot 90 degree, left foot in. Arm by the side. Then inhale and exhale. Go as far as possible. Hold air, 5 long J breath. 1, 2, 3, open the chest towards the left, right shoulder pushing in, 4, 5, inhale, all the way come up, exhale, change the side, your left foot out, right foot in, trunk above the pelvic, inhale and exhale, go as far as possible, place the palm and stretch your left arm up, back ribs into the body, front ribs lift it, and hold air. 5 breath. 1, Ujjayi breath. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Inhale, all the way come up. Palms onto the waist. Come in front edge of the mat. Okay, guys?
Can you please tell us what's the difference? Because from me, from what I'm seeing, the Hatha one and the Ashtanga looks the same to me. So what is the difference between the two when you say it's an Ashtanga one?
What is the difference between Ashtanga and Hatha? Okay.
No, the pose, yeah, that pose.
Okay, the pose is same. Okay. I'll give you, is the Hatha Yoga is the base. The all asana practice are coming from the Hatha Yogas. Hatha Yoga are the ancient yoga practice. The Lord Shiva are the first practitioner and first teacher of the Hatha Yoga.
Yes.
Okay. And then the Lord Shiva giving this knowledge. Lord Shiva was giving this knowledge to the Mother Parvati. To great service to mankind. Then that time what happened? The one fish was near the river. Then she listened this all the knowledge and learn all the knowledge by heart. And then one born child come, it's called Mashendranath. It's very famous. Mashendranath. Then Mashendranath giving this knowledge to the Gorakhnath. I think if you know the UP, the Uttar Pradesh is the right now the Gorakhnath. Right now is the Nath Samudaya are here. So this culture coming from the Nath Samudaya. So yoga practice, asana, hatha yoga practice coming from the ancient. And all the yoga practice coming from the hatha yoga. Then what happened? You know, the human beings are always dissatisfied.
Yeah.
He need to new things. So what happened? He make Ashtanga. He make anger. He make aerial. So he make lots of yoga practices. So Hatha Yoga is the base. And these are the modern yogas. The Ashtanga, anger, yin yoga, lots of yoga practices.
Like a variation. It's all variations.
These are the variations.
Okay.
Every teacher, somebody have a knowledge. In a just thing, what we call, I think in a, I think the hot yoga. So just every teacher make his own yoga sequence, vinyasa, ashtanga vinyasa. So it's just a modern, because human being are all, he want always new things. So he make new yoga. If you want, you are doing 10 years practice. You also make your yoga class. You can make your all your sequence. This is your yoga practice. So it's happened. But what happened? The human beings want always something new. So he make his own sequence. Okay, guys. There's nothing different. Posture is same. Posture is same. Just he give a variation. Give a technique. Just think, Ashtanga is not for everyone. Because some person are flexible. Some person have young. So he can easily do the Ashtanga. If it's not possible, then what we will be doing? So then some person are doing yin yoga, some person are doing Iyengar yoga. So depends.
But here, sir, the Ashtang pose looks easier than the Hatha pose, Hatha yoga pose. No, he goes straight on the side.
Ashtanga yoga pose are easier.
No, this one, the Trikon Asana, which you did just now. This looked easier than the Hatha Yoga Trikona Asana.
According to me, both are same, but just it's just a difference. It's just open the leg. It's not Ashtanga Yoga is different. Jump ke saath. Just I'll show you the jump with the Ashtanga class. Okay. Palms onto the waist. Bend the knees. Swing your right leg back. Left foot in, right foot out. Arm by the side. Trunk above the pelvic. Inhale and exhale. Go as far as possible. Ashtanga have only 5 breath. You have hold air in one posture, 5 breath. Then inhale, come up. Exhale, change the side. Inhale and exhale. It's very fast. Ashtanga class, if you are using the breath, you are using the breath fastly. In Hatha yoga, you are stable, calm. Then go to the posture.
Otherwise, it's same. Both the
posture is same. Benefit same. But Ashtanga have a particular sequence. The Kepatthabi joys make this sequence.
Okay.
It's a complete series. 52 posture. I think I'm not sure, but I think in this posture, lots of postures sequence. So we are doing this sequence together. That's why Ashtanga practice is very intense. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you.
So, Ashtanga is a sequence. I just show you one pose, but this is just a Trikonasana. But in this posture, lots of posture we are adding, then make a sequence. This is called Ashtanga Vinyasa sequence.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah, the benefits are same. Just the methods are different. If you want to do in a Hatha yoga like that, you can do also like that. Come in front edge of the mat. Front edge of the mat. If you want to do Hatha yoga practice like that, you can do this. Nobody say this is wrong. Okay. Inhale, right leg back, left foot in, right foot out, arm by the side. You can do this. Don't worry. If you are comfortable with this, you can do this. Okay. It's not ki only Ashtanga we can do like that. It's not necessary. It depend upon your comfort. If you are comfortable in this sequence, in this way, you can do this way. This is also Hatha yoga practice.
Okay. Thank you.
But in Ashtanga, it's a sequence. Clear?
Okay,
yes. Okay. So one more thing, if you have a high blood pressure and low blood pressure, so don't do this posture. Okay, guys. High blood pressure, low, because what happened? Adjustment alignment class is just not meaning, okay, just do the posture. Which time we do this posture and which time we are not doing this posture, it's very well. Somebody have a migraine pain, so don't do this posture. If you have a diarrhea, don't do this posture. And this posture is good for the sciatica pain. If you have a sciatica pain, so you can apply this posture. It's beneficial for you.
If you have lower back pain, we can do it, sir.
Yes, if you have a lower back pain also, so what do you think? It's good or wrong?
I think good. No? It's
better. If you have a lower back pain, so don't do this posture too much.
Because
the spine are more extended, so it's pressure going more. So that's why don't do this posture.
But sciatica good, you're saying. So lower back pain, no. Sciatica
is just a nerves. It's between the spine. It's compressed. Yeah. That's why we are extending the spine. So it's relief. And then it circulate the blood circulation properly. Oh. That's why.
अच्छा
तो सर्दिया नर्व्स गोइंग इनटू द स्पाइन सो व्हाट हैपेंड द स्पाइन आर कंप्रेस्ड टू द दिस द द द नर्व्स दैट्स व्हाई द पेन कमिंग बिकॉज़ सर्कुलेशन आर नॉट प्रॉपर्ली दैट्स व्हाई
ओके मिडिल बैक पेन मिडिल बैक पेन सॉरी अगर मिडिल बैक पेन है तो कर सकते हैं
यू कैन डू मिडिल बैक पेन इट्स फाइन बट सर्वाइकल पेन सो डोंट डू दिस इन अ सर्वाइकल पेन यू कैन लुक डाउन बट इट्स टू मच पेन इनटू अ सर्वाइकल डोंट डू दिस because pressure going to the neck because your neck is hanging in this posture you feel clear
yes sir
apply this posture with the alignment day by day definitely automatically observe your body it's not just I'll demonstrate here you think okay we know the right alignment how can you reach the right alignment if you are daily doing this posture practice otherwise you just know okay this is the alignment right now you do definitely doing something wrong because muscles are not flexible okay guys so right yes. now you are surviving the posture definitely but day by day you can reach this point clear
yes sir
clear the things understand don't worry next session we will be discuss if you want you can join the course then we will be more discuss about this courses this posture okay
okay sir
Okay, so next posture, you are ready? Ready for next posture?
Yes, sir.
Okay, same next posture is the open pelvic posture. It's called Veerbhadrasana B, Warrior B. Okay, so feel like a warrior. In this time, the COVID-19 hits. Everybody are surviving. So that's why feel like a warrior. So everybody ready? Come in front edge of the mat. Same how to do this posture. So come in front edge of the mat. Yes. Can you hear me, guys?
Yeah.
Okay. So the next pose is a. Okay, next posture is the Veerbhadrasana B. So palms onto the waist, bend the knee, inhale, swing your right leg 4 and 4.5. Okay, left foot in same alignment. Everybody know the triangle pose alignment. Everybody know it. The Trikonasana alignment. Everybody know it. So same alignment are here. Right foot 90 degree. Right heel and left middle arch in one line. Arm by the side. Trunk above the pelvic. Okay, guys. So alignment is same. Just a difference is legs are open 4 and 4.5 feet apart in a triangle. 3, 3.5, and 4 feet apart. So depend upon your flexibility. So if you are flexible, if you have a good range of motion, you are. Flexible, you can open 4 or 4.5. Okay, arm by the side, trunk above the pelvic. And according to the height, if somebody are 6 feet apart, his height is 6 feet, so he can open more. Okay, so arm by the side, trunk above the pelvic. Alignment is same. See your right heel and left middle arch should be in one line. Clear? Same like a triangle posture, Uthita Trikonasana, same alignment. Trunk above the pelvic, leg muscles engage. So your leg muscles should be engaged, trunk above the pelvic. So do not tilt your trunk, arm by the side, arms aligned with the shoulder, spread the finger. So your right heel and left heel are thoda. Okay? So how to do this posture? Okay, so inhale and exhale. Bend your right knee. So make sure your trunk not moving forward. Your trunk will be straight, just bending the knee. and gaze your right middle finger. Trunk above the pelvic, gaze your right middle finger. Right middle finger, trunk, turn your right neck. Hyperextended aorta. Good. Trunk, reach here.
Yeah.
You can see the warrior, feel like a warrior. And if it's possible, to bring your right knee over your right ankle, not far than onto your ankle. This is wrong. See? So your knee and ankles are your right knee and right side of the ankle in one line. If it's not possible, it's back. This is fine. But it's not far than onto your ankles. Clear? Clear, guys? So it's your right knee not far than onto your ankles. It's over the ankle, you're behind. But make sure your trunk above the pelvic. Clear? Yes. Okay, guys. Yes. What are you saying? Clear, guys?
Yes.
Okay. First, Asmina. Okay. Yes, okay. Asmina.
When we turn the foot, we turn with the heel or with the metatarsal?
Both are turning.
Ah, both.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Okay, so your right heel, left middle arch in one line. Make sure your knee and ankles are in one line if it's possible, because if muscles are flexible, then you can easily reach. But not possible, it's behind. But most important thing, your trunk above the pelvic. So if your trunk are not above the pelvic, what happened? Show trunk aage piche kar de. See what happened? If your trunk are not above the pelvic, it's not like a warrior. So what happened? Your trunk are in one line. Mm-hmm. And see, he is flexible. Ravikant is flexible. So his knee and ankles are in one line. But if you are not flexible, what you will be doing? Yes. But the most important thing, your trunk above the pelvic.
Shows when the trunk is not above the pelvic, I can't make out. Show how it is if the trunk is...
Because muscles not allow you, so it's bent.
Achha. Okay.
Okay, because muscles are not flexible, so definitely starting time, your trunk going back, sometime forward. But you will be doing, if it's possible, day by day, try to align the body and try to be strong your legs. Clear?
So the trunk and the pelvis must be in the same line.
Yes.
And facing forward.
Yes. It's very important. Okay. This is the pose, Tadasana. This is the Tadasana.
Yes.
Why? Because my trunk above the pelvic. So my internal organs are completely aligned. It's not only align the body outsidely, internally also your internal organs are also aligned. That's the very important thing. Right now it's aligned. My body are aligned. My internal organs are all also aligned. Okay, right now, what happened? My trunk are not above the pelvic. How can we say this is the right alignment? So same things. My trunk above the pelvic. My trunk above the pelvic. Okay? This is right?
No.
So my trunk above the pelvic, just bending the knee. Okay? So most important, starting time, definitely these muscles are pulling you forward. But your goal is to be stay here and feel the muscles. Clear?
Yeah. Yes, thank you.
Good. Yes. Any questions you have? Try. Come in front edge of the mat. Relax. Relax. So bring your right leg back 4 and 4.5 feet apart. Good. Left foot in, right foot out. Right foot out 90 degree. Yes. Check. Everybody first check. Your right heel and left middle arch in one line. First check. Very good. Leg muscles engage. Strong your legs. Arm by the side. Very good. Take a couple of breath in this posture. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Just take a couple of breath. Then inhale and exhale. Bend your right knee onto your right ankle. Trunk above the pelvic. Very good. Trunk above the pelvic. Good. Are you feel the muscles pulling you more forward towards the right side? Very good. Yes. Mariam, little bit, try to trunk straight. Trunk, yes. And try to bend the knee more. Very good. Trunk, try to straight more. Good, Radhika, very nice. Spread the finger and gaze your right middle finger. Anadi, you have a good space. Try to open your leg more. Yes, try to bend your right knee more. Good. Engage your right middle finger. Very good. Very nice, Radhika. Very nice, Anadi. Good. Asmina, very good. Open your leg, Asmina, more if it's possible. Good. One, hold here. Two, yes. Mariam, try to trunk straight. Three, just feel somebody pulling you back. Somebody pulling you left side. Then inhale, come up. Change the side. Change the side. Very good. Good. So your belly in, Mariam, your belly into the body, buttocks in. Yes. Are you feel? Engage your right middle, left middle finger. One, very good, Asmina, very nice. Two, three, four, and five. Inhale, all the way come up. Exhale, come in front, edge of the mat. Relax, shake your legs, move your leg, relax. Take your seat. Clear?
Yeah.
Yes. Any questions you have? So you feel what the importance of the alignment in the postures? If you're doing a wrong posture, definitely it's not beneficial for you. How much practice you did? Most of the persons said me, okay, I did 3 hours in a practice. But if you're not doing a right alignment with the practice, it's not beneficial. You, it's hurting you and it's not a yoga. Okay, guys.
What is the name of asanas?
Yes. What is the name?
Of asanas.
This asana name? This asana name is Veerbhadra Asana, Warrior B.
Okay, thanks.
Now, in Ashtanga, it's the same pose as well.
Yes, in Ashtanga also this pose is same.
Same, yeah. But it's just part of a sequence.
Yes, Ashtanga is the particular sequence. The founder of Ashtanga Vinyasa is K. Pattabhi Joyce. He made this sequence in a Mysore, in a Karnataka. So he's the teacher. I think 1926 he made this sequence in Mysore.
Krishnamurti.
Yes. No.
His guru name is P. Krishnamurti.
Okay.
P. Krishnamacharya. Okay. The K. Pattabhi Joyce teacher name is
Krishnamacharya.
Trimurti Krishnamacharya. Yes. So both are making this sequence. But if somebody asks you the question, who is the founder of Ashtanga Vinyasa, is the K. Pattabhi Joyce.
Sorry, what is the name? I just want to hear it.
K. Pattabhi Joyce.
Okay.
Okay, guys.
Okay.
So the most important thing, this class for the adjustment alignment. So the most important thing, you realize the importance of the adjustment and alignment. Right now, I didn't give you how to adjust. Adjustment is more deeper. Okay, but self-adjustment is very important. With yourself, you can use the blocks, you can use the props. Okay, then you can adjust yourself. If you have a next session, definitely we will discuss how to adjust the person. Okay,
but right now the most important. What is the meaning of adjustment?
Okay, very simple. The very simple, just think, if you are not reaching into the posture, and I am flexible, but we cannot reach this posture in a right alignment. So we are doing the adjust the person to reaching this posture. So try to go deeper into the posture. That's why we are using the hand adjustment. And yeah, props we can use. Just think, the Asmina are flexible. She know the alignment, but she cannot reaching. She's flexible, but she cannot reach this posture. So I can give we can use the props, we can use the hand adjustment, then we can reach this posture into the pose. Okay, it's a three type of the adjustment. First with the through, with the command. Second with the props adjustment. And third one is hand adjustment. Okay, guys.
Okay.
Clear the things?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
So the point is, if you understand this thinking, importance of the adjustment is, what is the importance of the adjustment? Clear? Why we need a alignment and adjustment. Adjustment is more deeper, but right now just talking about the alignment is very important. So that's why the person are doing practice, but without the alignment, if you are doing practice, definitely you hurt yourself. So need a right alignment. Okay. Clear?
Okay. Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, guys, so let's ending the session. Yes, any questions you have, any posture alignment, if you want to know, you can ask me.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, so next session, we will be discuss another postures. Okay, guys.
So what is your name?
My name is Suraj.
Oh, because we got the email that some Mr. Negi will be taking the class. That's why I'm asking.
Yes, Suraj Negi is my name.
Okay.
Suraj Negi is my name.
Okay, sir.
Negi is my caste.
Okay.
Suraj like the sun.
Yes, it's meaning is sun.
One question before we close the session. You said our right nostril faces the sun and the left nostril, I didn't hear what you said.
The moon.
About the left nostril.
We have a two nadis, right side and left side. So right side is represent the sun and left side represents the moon.
The moon. Oh, yes, the sun.
So sun energy and moon energy we have.
Okay.
That's why in a morning time, slowly, slowly the sun is raising, our energy going higher.
Yes.
But slowly, slowly the night will become, so moon energy will be higher, then we are sleep.
Less, yeah. Okay, exactly. Understood.
That's why we are
very good explanation. Very good. Thank you.
That's why we are using the right side. In a pranayama class, the more you will discuss more with the right side nostril and left side nostril.
Okay.
That's why we are doing the pranayama to cleansing our nadis, right side and left side. Sun energy and moon energy.
It's okay, the first time I'm hearing about that. Thank you.
Okay. If you want more detailing, you can join the courses. We also organize the Adi Yoga School, organize the teacher training courses. So come and join us. The more the good teachers are here to explain the things.
Yes, very good teachers there. Very good teachers. Thank you.
Okay, guys. Let's ending the session.
Sir, you teach pranayama also?
No, I teach just, I all know it pranayama also, but I just teach, I'm professional in Ashtanga, Hatha and adjustment alignment. Yeah, but I know it how to do the pranayama. I teach also, but I teach most of the time asana classes, asana and adjustment alignment.
Okay.
Okay, guys.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Let's ending the session. Sit in simple cross leg, palms onto the knees, eyes close. Join the palm in front of the chest, Anahat Chakra. We are going to chant one times Om's together, then Santi. Take a deep breath in. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Move your head down. Hey Guru. Move your head up. Rub your palms. Place the palms over the closed eyes. Again, rub the palms. Place the palms onto your neck. Namaste. Thank you. Thank you very much. Open your eyes.
Yeah.
Namaste. Okay, guys.